All right. Thank you, Alan. That was a tremendous presentation. Reminds you of the spiritual value of this message, what it really means. And one of the things for me that was a real attractor was the fact that so many people I had read prior to the Russell's work, the similarities of the writings, though the words may vary, the meaning was the same. When you get beyond the words and understand the actual meaning, words become unnecessary. It's really quite an amazing revelation in oneself. It's great to be able to say we have brought someone over from an international scene, Hannah van Houcke, who is from Belgium, a civil engineer in construction, an architect with a Master of Science degree in engineering and architecture, fellow architect like Dr. Russell, specializing in urban design and planning. She became very interested in the works of Walter Russell about 3 years ago after reading A New Concept of the Universe and started an intensive personal study of all available Russell material. She has advanced experience in 3D modeling, visualization techniques, graphic and web design. The software she uses is especially for architectural and engineering design that gives a certain kind of graphic result. New visualizations of the Russell teachings require a new language and deeper understanding of geometry, which make it easier to grasp some of these concepts. Her work on Russell's material is a marriage between the rhythmic thinking of an artist and the mathematical precision of scientific thinking. Many of her drawings, which she's been putting out many lately, I wonder, often we text every once in a while over Messenger, and I'll ask her if she's having an illumination, because 20, 30 pictures within a few hours, couple days, she's very prolific, very inspired. We're honored to have you here, Hannah. Please come on up.
Hi, everybody.
Hello. I'm Hannah. So I'm not going to give a speech today, but I'm going to overload you with lots of images and drawings. So I want to present you a video on the work I did based on Walter Russell's cubic wave field. So I hope you will enjoy it. Thank you.
Hidden within the wave are clues to a mystery. Something that could help answer one of humanity's most enduring question. Why is the world the way it is? Thank you.
mathematical explanation for how bad your tie is.
Number of the day, I present to you the number. number of the day is 2.
So that's the number, yes, 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 that's the number, yes, yes, that's the number, yes, the number of the day. That's the number, yes, yes, that's the number of the day.
That's the way, we like it. Thank you. as an owl.
That's the way, we like it,
Are there questions?
Can we see it again?
It will be uploaded to YouTube. Question here.
Hey, I'm trembling. That was the most amazing presentation. Thank you so much.
Oh my God.
You're welcome.
Can you make the little Einstein guy?
Hey Hannah, did you just show us something most profound and significant with what you learned mapping out 9 octaves and 10 octaves? And what did you uncover there? I began to tremble. My body saw yin yang and this like overlapping waveform that I've worked with so many times.
Well, there's a fundamental difference if you start to build it up. When you build up the 10 octave, you will see that the inert gases and the sounds, they are all in the same plane with the 10 octave. With the 9 octave, you will never get the inert gases in one plane. Only the middle points and not the rings. So they do not align on the inertial plane. So that's the fundamental difference. So that's why I think the 9 octave is the way he intended it to be. But you can only see that if you build up the entire wave.
Right, which because I can't do 3D modeling is exactly why I've never been able to see it. And
see it that they do not lay in the same plane.
Do you think that implies the 10 octaves is correct?
I know, I think that implies that the 9 octave is correct.
Ah.
Because they...
waver. I see. Thank you.
I have a comment and a question. My comment is I feel like I haven't even begun to learn the science. And the question is, how much RAM do you have on your computer?
Obviously a lot.
It's a joke. You don't have to actually answer.
I just have a short question. Jackson Pollock, another artist, I've recently learned that, you know, his work is so random, but ultimately he's the only human whose work is actually fractal. And it's only in recent years that they've used machinery
to
approximate what he is a human being, because no one can understand why we're attracted to Pollock's work.
I've seen his work.
It was so far from random, it was actually perfect fractals done by a human being. So you're aware of that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I've seen it. The machine to replicate his work, yeah.
Yeah,
I've seen it. Yeah.
Hannah, this emotionally affected me. And when I see this, it's like if this was a download, we just got a caught teaching. It was that powerful, looking at diagrams. You know, they're nice, you can study them, but this was just taken in. We just took it in. I did anyway. Fantastic, thank you.
Thank you.
Another round of applause for...